neutral side action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Bowling Green is getting fired up down there as they get ready to boot this opening kickoff. He'll take it from the two. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Tackle made at the 23. From their own 23-yard line, it's second down. Around the 30-yard line. That series left the offense scratching their heads a little.
They did a pretty good job of not letting the offense get much going on that possession.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. Out of bounds, around the 28-yard line. So here comes the offense taking the field for the first time today. Goes out of bounds at about the 31. Fires across the middle, and he's tackled at the 33.
Sure if the back was his first option, but he got in the ball and he was able to make something big happen.
Nice run there. The tailback broke that one for a very nice game.
Give the offensive line some kudos there. They blocked very well up front to create the holes for this back. Well, the defense has to be very frustrated there. They did everything. They got to the quarterback. In fact, it looked like they had a chance to bring him down for the sack. And somehow, he's able to throw the ball away.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 45. They'll bring him down at the 45. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. And he's shoved out of bounds at the 29-yard line.
A pass like that is so hard to defend because the defender doesn't have a great play on the ball unless it's underthrown. It's all based on connection between the quarterback and his receiver.
Looks like he flinched down there on the line.
False start.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
So we'll have first and 15 after the penalty.
Mike 51.
Throws. The defender had it and then dropped it.
It can be tough making a play on the ball sometimes, but that's probably a pick he should have made.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Quick throw to the tight end. Tackled at about the 23-yard line.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. They'll spread the field with five wide. Throws incomplete. And so now the ball's turned over on downs. I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. The quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Good open field tackle. From their own 37-yard line, first down. They come out in an empty backfield. Throws complete, and he's hit right away. To that quickly. He's tackled at the 46-yard line. What a throw for a big game.
That is a great example of the quarterback seeing the whole field and finding the guy who had the best chance of making a catch.
From the 46-yard line, first down. Throws it in a hurry. He's knocked out of bounds at the 36-yard line. Brought down at the 34. Gain 2 yards. First down. From the 34-yard line, it's first down. And they make the stop around the 25-yard line. That's a D. He gets out to about the 25-yard line. Here's the eighth play of the series. Taken down around the 29-yard line.
The thing about the option is you're going to have some negative plays, but if you keep running it, it'll create some big play opportunities.
They'll call on the field goal unit here for this long field goal attempt. Western Michigan could take the lead with this field goal. The kick is up, and he nails the long field goal. There are three quarters remaining. The Broncos with a three-point lead. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff.
Number 24, deep to return.
Taken from the 3-yard line. He's taken down at the 25. Well, Welcome back. Tight game here in the second quarter as we begin play.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays.
He's taken down at the 33-yard line. Nice run, and he's brought down. Tackle after a decent run up the gut. Gets out to about the 42-yard line. It's caught. First down, and he's out of bounds. It out to about the 44-yard line. From the 44-yard line, second down. He makes it out to maybe the 43-yard line. They're trying to pin them deep with a solid punt right here. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes. Western Michigan is up by three. He steps out at the 24. It's second and six. Ball on their own 24.
You like a team that's ready to defend the pass. It takes some preparation to get in the way of a pass like that.
From their own 31-yard line, second down. And now he's got room to run. He's got it out to his tight end. Setting up blockers, a running back's got it on the screen. That's a great tackle at the 40-yard line. That screen pass nets maybe 5 yards. Bowling Green's going to take their first time out of the half. He's tackled at the 28-yard line. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Carries the ball for a nice game. Right,
slides forward to about the 36. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. Tackled after a decent pickup. He's got it with room to run, and he's immediately tackled. Just throws this one away.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Caught, open field. Tackle made right around the 28-yard line. That one goes for good yardage and a first down.
Yeah, that's just a nice gain on second down.
From the 28-yard line, first down. Strike to his receiver, no good. This is the eighth play of this drive. Slings it out there incomplete. He's unable to hit his receiver. He overthrew it.
Yeah, and that's a throw he should make every single time.
And here's another third down.
Great job by the defense of getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
Mike 51, Mike 51.
And he's sacked. Huge play for the defense. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Western Michigan has a three-point lead. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. From their own 48-yard line, first down.
Good job here by the defense. If you let this quarterback set and throw, he'll kill you all game. But they got excellent pressure on that play.
And they got it.
Absolutely perfect call by the defensive coordinator. He brought just the right amount of pressure from the right direction, and it seemed to confuse the offense.
Third down now, and they need to get it inside the 42. Steps out of bounds. Right around the 48-yard line. Everybody up close. It looks like they're coming after this kick. This one will go into the end zone, and they'll bring it out to the 20. Right now, this game's got all the makings of maybe being a nail biter.
Yeah, this game just feels like it's going to go well into the second half, probably into the fourth quarter. You almost have a feel that maybe one of the defenses may have to score a touchdown to be able to win this game.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Tackled for a loss. From their own 19-yard line. Second down. Low scoring first half of play, but a close game. The Broncos with a three-point lead.
We've played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. David, I'm sure there are plenty of people out there just loving this game. I mean, these two teams are spinning the magic bean all over the yard. Big numbers on offense, pitch and catch, run after the catch, all the offense is working.
Yeah, there's nothing to talk about defensively, but if offensively, if you want to start talking about, I mean, everything that you're doing is right. And to be able to throw it deep, to be able to throw it short, to be able to make the defense honor every part of the field, the offenses are really in rhythm. They're really in a groove, and this is one of those games that you see a lot on the West Coast. I mean, it seems like there's not a lot of defense, but the offenses know what they want to do and how they want to do it, and the scoreboard just goes.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio with the best seat in the house. Belongs to Brad Nessler and Kirk Herbstreit.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And he's taken down at the 24-yard line. The Broncos continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Taken down in the backfield.
These guys have the capability to gain solid, consistent yardage. They have to regroup, come out a bit more motivated next time.
From their own 23-yard line, it's second down. Here's the give. And he's tackled around the 23-yard line. Takes it up the middle for a nice run. He's at midfield, brought down at the 48-yard line. So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. Western Michigan holds a field goal lead. He's at the 40, short over the middle. They'll bring him down at the 34-yard line. From the 34-yard line, it's first down.
Watch two, watch two. Mike seven. Green 90.
He goes out of bounds at the 31-yard line.
Gain 3 yards. That'll make it second and seven.
Gets it quickly to the tight end, but it's dropped.
Number 46 was the intended receiver.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 24. Throws complete, and he stopped immediately. Pitch play here. Nice run to the outside. From the 18-yard line, first down. Now he
tries to buy some time. And now he's going to run. And down he goes at the 6-yard line.
That makes it first and goal.
Western Michigan is up a field goal. On the toss, stop behind the line. It's second and goal. Ball on the 8-yard line. Quick strike, tight end, and that's a touchdown. And he hits the PAT. A nice 8-play, 49-yard drive. And a touchdown as a result. So the score now, 10-0. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He's to the 20. Gets out to about the 21. There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Little handoff. He's to the 40. And they finally make the stop at the 47-yard line. That was a huge lift.
Brad, you're right. A run like that can really get the momentum rolling.
He's tackled around the 36-yard line. The stop at about the 21. And he's taken down around the 21-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
Complete. He's got room. He's out of bounds at the 11. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 11. And they get nice yardage on that run.
That's a deep 5 on the play. That brings him second and 5.
Touchdown, Falcons.
This back has great vision, which allows him to make runs like this one we just saw.
Here's the point after to try to cut this to a 3-point game. And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. From his own goal line, he's to the 20. And down he goes at the 29-yard line. The quarterback is on his way back onto the field, and he led a great drive last time out. Western Michigan is up by 3. Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receiver. From their own 29-yard line, it's second down. Pressured and brought down.
I think this defensive end is doing a great job of getting after the quarterback, not only with the sack in this case, but it seems like the entire game he's done a good job of creating pressure, making this quarterback feel him, and almost giving him happy feet back there. He doesn't seem to be in rhythm and almost seems to be throwing the football, feeling the pressure and almost creating nerves on the quarterback.
So the sack makes this third and very long. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. He's to the 40. Brought down at the 43-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 43. At about the 41.
That's good for a game of 16 yards. First down.
From the 41-yard line, first down. Complete. He's got room to work. He's taken down around the 34-yard line. That's three down and one to go. The Broncos with a three-point lead. Great three quarters of action. Tight ball game. And now it's the fourth quarter, and this will decide it. Western Michigan has a three-point lead. Caught with room to work. That's a great tackle at the 16. First and 10. Ball on the 16-yard line. Gets to about the 14-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Nice run up the middle. So it's third down now, and they're going to need about four. Completes it, but he can't shake the defense. Kicks away, and it's through the uprights. Looks like they're ready for the kick. He'll return it from the one. Across the 30. And now the ball is loose. He picks it up. He finally goes down at the 33-yard line. So the offense will come out onto the field to take over once again.
They got 3 points on their last drive. But with this kind of field position, they should be looking to get the ball into the end zone.
The middle.
That brings him second and five.
Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 28-yard line. Western Michigan is up by six.
Green 19.
tackled right away. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 17. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Pickup. Bowling Green's going to take their first time out of the half. Second down, goal to go. Ball on the 3. They're trying to stop the run here with a goal line defense. Got the corner. Touchdown, Western Michigan. So the offense is going to go for 2. Just under 2 to go in the game. And they won't get the 2. So the 2-point conversion is no good.
Here they try to put the ball in the air. Unfortunately, they were unable to convert.
They line up to kick this one away. He'll take it from the 2. He makes it out maybe to the 26-yard line. So the offense comes out after their last drive had the ball end up in the defense's hands by way of a fumble.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
Fires out to his receiver, and he's tackled at the 42. They'll spread the field here. Let's see what the defense does with a 5-wide outlook. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. They'll bring him down around the 49-yard line. 5-wide. Makes the catch and gets out of bounds.
He is such a reliable target. You throw it anywhere near him, and this guy's going to get his hands on it and make a catch.
From the 35-yard line, it's first down. Quick throw to the tight end. Knocked out of bounds at the 28. Catches another, and he tackles him hard at the 19-yard line. Bowling Green will have one timeout remaining. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 19-yard line. Under a minute left in the game. Quick shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball. Strike, and he drops it.
Terrific coverage, and when you clog up passing lanes like that, you could force a quarterback to make some poor decisions. Almost got themselves a turnover, too.
From the 19-yard line, third down.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback. And right now, I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
The cavalry's coming. He's hit and taken down.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated them there.
Spikes the ball. And this is the 12th play of the drive. Touchdown. Late in the fourth quarter, and the big question is, in a game this close, who's going to crack first? And he converts the extra point. Out to about the 38-yard line.
So they recover the kick, and now the game's probably in their hands. If they can hang on to the ball or score, I don't see how they can lose.
I'm sure that touchdown in their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field.
This offensive coordinator's got to be feeling so good about the execution that he's seeing from his quarterback and his wide receiver. Because, again, they put so much time into trying to put a plan together, and to be able to see that actually come into play makes you feel pretty good as a play caller.
This one's in the books, and our final score, 19-14, Broncos. EA Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. This is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.